Welcome to a lesson on solving logarithmic equations. There are really two types of log equations we're going to take a look at in this video. The first type is when you have an equation that has only two logs of the same base. And if that's the case, if we set the logs equal to each other, as we see here, then it follows that the argument of the first log must equal the argument of the second log. So we'll set those equal to each other and then solve. Now we do have to check our answers though, because the argument of the log has to be greater than zero. So if we obtain a value that makes this less than or equal to zero, we would have to exclude it. Let's go ahead and try a couple of these first. So notice we have two logs with base 5 equal to each other. Therefore, it follows that 12 must equal 2x minus 3. So now we can solve this for x. We'll add 3 to both sides. That would give us 15 equals 2x. Then dividing both sides by 2, we have x equals 15 halves, or we could say 7.5. Let's go ahead and check this. And this one's pretty straightforward. 2 times 7.5, that'd be 15 minus 3, that'd be 12. So we have log 12 on the right and log 12 on the left, so that solution checks. This next one is very similar, except we have to set the two logs equal to each other first. So if we add log base 7 of 10 to both sides of the equation, we would have log base 7 of x squared minus 3x equals log base 7 of 10. And if the logs are equal to each other, then x squared minus 3x must equal 10. Well, now we have a quadratic equation. Let's set it equal to 0 and see if it factors. Subtracting 10 on both sides. There are factors of negative 10 that add to negative 3. It would be x minus 5 and x plus 2. So from this, we have a solution of x equals 5 and x equals negative 2. Now, we do need to check these solutions. Let's go ahead and check the equation in this form. Let's just make sure this is equal to positive 10 for both of these x values. When x equals 5, we'd have 5 squared minus 3 times 5. We'd have 25 minus 15, which equals 10. That checks. And now let's try x equals negative 2. Negative 2 squared is 4 minus 3 times negative 2. That'd become plus 6. 4 plus 6 does equal 10. So both solutions check. Now there are guidelines for solving the more general type of log equation, and here are the steps. If there is more than one log, combine them using the properties of logs. Then we want to isolate the single log, and then we're going to write the equation in exponential form, solve, and check. These are the properties that we do have to be aware of, the product, quotient, and power property, and sometimes the change of base formula. Let's take a look at some of these problems. In order to isolate the log, we'll first divide both sides of the equation by 2. That's going to give us log base 3 of 3x equals 3. So now that we have a single log, we're going to rewrite this in exponential form. So 3 to the power of 3 must equal 3x. And now we're going to solve this equation and then check our solution. Well, 3 to the third would be 27. So now we divide both sides by 3. We have x equals 9. Let's go ahead and check x equals 9 in this form of the equation. So if x equals 9, we'd have the log base 3 of 27 equals 3, and 3 to the third does equal 27, so it checks. Let's try another. So we want to combine these two logs. Since the two logs are being added together, we can multiply the number part of the log. So we can combine these into log base 5 of x minus 2 times x plus 2 equals 1. Let's go ahead and multiply this out. This is going to be x squared plus 2x minus 2x, that's 0, and then minus 4 equals 1. We have a single log, so now we'll rewrite this in exponential form. 5 to the first power must equal x squared minus 4. Let's go ahead and add 4 to both sides. We'll have x squared equals 9. Now we can square root both sides of the equation. Remember, we're going to have two solutions from this. X equals plus or minus 3. Let's go ahead and check those solutions. When x equals 3, we're going to have log base 5 of 1, that's 0, plus log base 5 of 3 plus 2, that'd be 5. Log base 5 of 5 equals 1, that's true, so that solution checks. X equals negative 3 is going to be a problem because when we sub in negative 3 here for x, we're going to have log base 5 of negative 5, which is not in the domain of this logarithm, therefore it's not a solution. We only have one solution to this equation. Let's go ahead and try one more. Now we want to combine these two logs, but it's a difference. Remember, if it's a difference, then this is going to end up being the log of a quotient. We're going to have log base 16 of x divided by x minus 1 equals 1/4. We have a single log now, so we'll rewrite this in exponential form. 16 to the power of 1/4 must equal this quotient. 16 to the 1/4 power is equal to 2. We can rewrite 16 as 2 to the 4th, to the 1/4, which would give us just 2 to the 1st. This is 2 must equal x divided by x minus 1. What I would probably do here is put this over 1. We have a proportion, so we can cross multiply. 2 times x minus 1 must equal 1 times x, which is x. So now we can solve this equation. 2x minus 2 equals x. Let's go ahead and subtract 2x on both sides. Negative 2 equals negative x. Now we can divide by negative 1 if we want. X equals 2. Notice when x equals 2, we have log base 16 of 2 minus log base 16 of 1. This would be 0. 16 to the 1/4 equals 2, so this does check. The main reason for checking these is the argument that the log has to be greater than 0, and if it's not, it would not be a solution. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Have a nice day.